Okay, we're in the education building for the church in this
Minka village.
Behind me, if you could see the guy, I positioned myself so you could see Pastor Pedro. That's him. I'll scooch over. That's Pastor Pedro standing there. He had a vision for these a burden for these people in 2002, and he began his work up here in 2006, and there's this huge church building that the church in Roatan, Pastor Timothy's dad, I think, donated a lot of the money to build this enormous building. It's as big as the church in Roatan, the church building, and I think you could fit 500 people in there. The link is you might be able to fit more than that. I'm not sure. They're pretty small people. And so anyway, they built these two education buildings, dirt floor, very simple construction, metal roofs, courtesy of Pastor Norman's, Timothy Norman's dad. And so there's a lot of people around in the surrounding villages, apparently, and the gospel is bearing fruit and growing among them too. And as we've been sitting here, we've been here 30 minutes maybe, and there are a number of ladies who've showed up. One lady brought Pastor Pedro some coffee, which he gave to Pastor Timothy, who gave to Pastor Norman, who gave to Jonathan, because Jonathan gave Norman some coffee earlier, so giving it will be given unto you. And these mountains are really harsh. They're so steep in some cases, and the underbrush is very thick. And but there's a tenderness going on in the heart of the gospel. And so I'm just here to report to you from Honduras that Jesus is alive, that he's working and freeing people. And the village is different because there are churches here. So this church is going to put in, wants to put in a center to feed children, both to help with the nourishment of some. A lot of families take good care of their kids, but apparently some do not, where there might be abuse or just neglect, wasting of resources by drinking. And the church is going to be about providing a place for hope and help for those families, in addition to providing the gospel in the middle of that. So feeding center as an evangelism tool, as well as a care for the needy. And in addition, we've talked a lot about providing, or really raising a culture from within and providing some technical assistance from without to improve agricultural outputs and a few other things. Hey, cute little dog just showed up in here. So you want to look at the dog? And all my children said, yes. So here's Puppy. Hey, Puppy. Hey, he's biting himself. Hey. Hi. Now he's licking himself. Well, that's all, he's biting some other stuff. So, dogs are everywhere. There are not many possums, rabbits, armadillos, or other small critters. You want to guess why they're not here? Well, I'll let you guess. But there is apparently a reserve that's not allowed to be hunted, and there are all of those critters. It's, I think, that way, I think. In that reserve, but not in the villages because, well, I'll just let you figure that one out. But all right, I'll be back in a minute.